Hello and welcome to the ASRC Oval Series season finale. For season 4, I do believe. Yeah. Season 4 of this year. And I actually don't know what place I'm in. In the standings right now. Give me one second. Let's see. Ah, there we go. Go to standings. It looks like I'm in ninth, and I'm just behind by 1 point. So just behind Jeremy. And also Nicholas is not that far behind, followed by Bill, Derek. And the people ahead is Eric and Jason, Jason Mong. But in all honesty, Jason Mong is just so far ahead in points that realistically we're just gonna, even Eric, Jeremy's gonna be the person that we're gonna be chasing for. And the Nicholas, Bill, even Derek, are they here? Yeah, Derek here, Nicholas, I don't think Nicholas is here yet. So, what about Garrett? Yeah, Garrett is here. So, without further ado, let's actually get rolling.
Let's radio see. Check. Spotter radio check. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, I can. I turned him off because he kept on interrupting at the beginning there, so. We got 2 minutes to actually set a lap, so we better actually get
pit lane speed
on.
Limit is 60 miles per hour. Looks like you're clear on the pit exit. Okay, Corey, we've got 2 laps to get the job done.
But yeah, we don't have a lot of pace. At least compared to the people, compared to the people racing tonight. I mean, we're kind of close, I guess, to some of the backfield, backfield people. But, I can't really set. Ooh, oh my goodness. Can't really set a fucking 57-1, holy shit. So I had a terrible outlap. Hopefully, I can make up on this lap. Will I even have a time for a second lap? I do believe so. Now, keep in mind, I have no idea how to drive Pocono in this track, really. I just kind of drive the track and drive it how it feels right, like it's right. I don't exactly look at a guide or anything like that. I shouldn't put on the gas. Alright then. turned in way too early. This lap is a wash. I would have probably had time if I would have done better on the lap, but
that's
whatever.
The end of the session. Eighth place.
It's fine. But yeah, I did about a 20 lap run before I decided to come in, and yeah, I was trying to take it easy, and was trying to learn the car, and stuff that I learned is to, if we come in around lap 20 or so, definitely only taking left sides. Or not left sides, right sides. My brain. Alright, hold on. I'm bringing back up the standings. There we go. We're definitely gonna have to stop for fuel. Gonna leave both of those on for now. Just better safe than sorry. I'm fully gonna expect to be finishing like 10th. You know, pretty much dead last. Because, like, even though I should be more comfortable at high speed tracks like this, Pocono is just one of those kind of awkward tracks for me.
P8, 60 laps.
Looks like some people didn't exactly qualify all that well, because I got Jason behind me.
We need to follow car number 38
or Gardner
in the inside lane.
There's two Jasons. Alright, so we got a little bit. I was wondering why people, why I was ahead of so many people. I guess they just had bad qualifying laps, to where they hit the wall or something and invalidated it. Alright, so I know there's 11 cars, so I don't want to finish dead last. I want to at least try to finish in the top 10. One pitching, you know, I want to fight for the wooden spoon, pretty much. Not gonna fight Gardner. I do believe I can't really say your name right, sorry. The 74.
Go, go, go.
I had such a bad start.
Oh,
I was actually also so far behind as well. I was so focused on trying to say his name right. Oh no.
Still there.
I felt the car going sideways.
This car on the low side. Hold your line. Keep this line. Alright, Corey, decent start. You can build something from here. Be on the inside.
I swear the car wants to, like, dip to the left. a lot of the times whenever I don't mean to. Holy shit. Okay. Learning from the cars ahead. I think I'm using way too much turn in and tires on the tunnel turn, but honestly, that's the most difficult turn in my opinion. Oh. I had a whoops. I knew he was going to be faster, but I was trying to let him by awkward. To be honest, that was kind of awkward.
Gap 2, Murphy, ahead is now 0.7.
But I didn't want to move suddenly on the line back to the outside. To be honest, this is probably just going to be a strategy race. Oh shit.
We've had a cut warning. Keep it tidy, please, Corey.
That turned a lot.
The fuel should open about lap 19, and it should close
okay,
on
19.
Lap 37.
Okay, so pitting around the time. I kind of stopped at qualifying, okay. But yeah, that kind of went unexpectedly in. Like, loose.
The leader's just done it, 57.1.
I think I put too much heat into my tires. Let's just keep it steady. Okay then. That wasn't as bad as it could have been.
58.6.
That was my fastest lap of the session. Me hitting a wall. My only real hope is for someone up ahead just to wreck and actually DNF. Which, I mean, it's the end of the season. I didn't exactly look at the standings all that well, but there might be some battles that need to be had. I know Brian, for one, is gonna want some revenge on his bad luck. Yeah, I must be driving this track really wrong. Do you like shift down or something? Well, I'm gonna try shifting down into turn one or something. Okay, so definitely not. So definitely not into turn three. Yeah, the car doesn't get low enough into turn one. Like, the only place that would kind of make a little bit of sense, I think, would be into turn three, but even then, that doesn't really make a lot, I don't know. I was headed straight for that wall.
Good lap. That's your quickest so far. So Murphy ahead is now 3.7 seconds.
Eric, when you get up here, just let me know where you want to go, because I got a little bit of damage to slow down. Yeah.
I'll let you know.
Well, took that turn way too wrong.
Alright, I'm gonna go here, okay?
Yeah, first.
That lap time was 58.8.
Thank you.
Okay, Corey, the next car is Sparks. Hess is leading the race. You're reeling, Sparks. Sparks in the gaps now, 2.4.
I wonder if we're going to be able to catch Sparks or not. Or if he's just going to follow Garrett. Got up on the marbles and that made the car loose, I think.
You've just done a 58.9. Sparks ahead is now 2.0. Just done a 58.5. Gap 2, Sparks in front is now 1.5.
Alright, he must have made a mistake. Yeah, he's gaining back a little bit of time.
That's your quickest lap.
Shit. Would've hit the wall if I didn't lift off.
The gap to Sparks ahead is increasing. It's now 1.5 seconds.
as of right now.
That lap time was 59.1.
Dare make the move.
Still there. Still with you. Clear outside. Now inside. Still there. Clear light.
I kinda knew that was gonna happen with the switchback.
Oh, good. I think we both did that this time now. You get super tight underneath the dirt for some reason.
Let's go for it again.
Still there. He's still there. Clear on the outside.
And we made it! Let's see if we could actually pull away.
10th position. You've just done a
59.2. Oh, that's such a bad turn. Oh shit. Yeah, around lap 20 is whenever, at least for me personally, the tires started to go a bit dead. Let's just pick it back up and just try to work it smooth. Honestly, it's probably from me just pushing. I just need to drive normally.
Murphy ahead is now.
Oh wow. We lost a lot of time.
Car outside.
Oh shit.
Keep your line. He's still there. Outside the clear.
The gap to Murphy behind is now 0.3.
My bad, Lucas. Mine's checked up and I didn't have anyone go.
Is there going to be a caution for that? Because we all backed out back here.
I mean, unless someone actually, like, wrecked and needed a tow, I wouldn't say so. But, I mean, that sucked if you backed out, and, I mean, honestly, that really does suck.
Leon, whoops, ahead is pitting. Eighth place.
Alright, let's mess with the brake bias just a little bit more. Alright, so we're actually in 8th, which is kind of surprising. Don't know what actual position we're going to end up in the...
74 is going to fit this lap.
Oh shit, okay. I guess it is kind of getting around pit stop range. I mean, we're already in the pit window. I'm gonna try, of course, because the car's behind. I think we're gonna try to stretch it out for as long as we can. What? What the fuck? Ah! Ah! Yeah, he's gonna probably get on the outside of us.
Okay, Corey, pit window is open.
Nope, we're not. Okay, I'll just take the outside if you let me.
God, no. The head is pitting. Six. You've just done 1 minute.
That's a bad turn.
The gap to Finney ahead is now 14 seconds.
Alright, I'm feeling pretty comfortable, actually. So I'm gonna stick it out. I'm gonna stick it out till I have to pit for, you know, till my fuel runs out, basically. Ooh, that's a bad corner. Ow. Come on. The track's like glue. Or the walls like glue, I should say. Blah.
Sparks behind is now 1.1 seconds. That was at 100.1 seconds.
Alright, so the car behind us is going to be pitting. Also, the leader, one of the leaders in front is pitting as well.
Okay, Corey, we're halfway home. We estimate 7 laps of fuel left.
Alright, I think to respond to the car behind pitting, I think I'm gonna do that here sooner rather than later, possibly. I'm just scared of pitting and then the yellow coming out. Oh shit. The only reason why I fucked that corner so hard is because I wasn't paying attention.
Murphy is closing you down. The gap has come down to 1.6 seconds.
I am just so paranoid of a caution coming out.
Murphy behind is pitting now.
Alright, so the other car behind me is pitting. Looks like we might actually go caution free.
The leader, Young, is pitting. Gap to Vinny ahead is increasing. It's now 14 seconds.
Alright, so not this lap, but next lap.
The gap behind has now decreased to 4.9. Vinny is now leading.
P3. Okay, looks like I'm the only one that hasn't pitted yet. Alright, let's pit on in. I have practiced this, but I'm still not used to this pit entry.
What's your speed limit in the pits? Pit lane speed limit is 60 miles per hour. Okay, Corey, we'll fill you to the end of the race. Fastest lap for Hess, 57.0. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box
okay, good.
Now.
Wow, 50 fucking, almost 50% tires. I should have probably came in a little bit earlier, but a... I also put myself in neutral, but a... A-O.
You're all clear, stay behind the line.
Whoa!
Murphy behind is now 2.4. Hess is leading the race.
Trying to keep up the pace. I'm gonna try everything in my power to keep this P10. That includes not killing these sets of tires.
fastest lap today.
The car got real bouncy. Okay, so yeah, 20 to go here soon. Car's feeling all right. Oop, almost missed my braking zone there. Fuck.
Relay sparks. Yeah, the gap is now 3.1.
I am. Granted, those last two turns weren't so impressive. But yeah, I'm just trying to be, you know, trying to push it, but also not try to over push it and not kill the tires. That was a bad corner. But not too terribly bad, it seems. At least compared to the people I'm racing to. Well, if we actually are catching the car ahead, then let's see if we can actually, catch the car ahead.
The relay sparks in the gap is 2.2.
Yeah, I'm not really exactly trying to. It's just happening naturally, so let's just keep on doing what we're doing. And, and if we don't make any mistakes, big mistakes, kind of like that, or that could have resulted in a big mistake, then we might be able to actually get a ninth place. I'm happy with 10th. It won't be dead last. But I'm also happy if we can get one more position. That was a bad exit. One thing about turn one, though, is I can't really get a good exit, it seems. The tunnel turn, though.
The next car is Sparks.
Ooh. Sparks looks like hit a wall just hit the wall just then. Yeah, I'm not saving tires anymore. I'm just trying to push as hard as I can, really. Hopefully my tires won't be dead by the time it actually matters. Like, I'm not pushing them too hard into 2 and 3, but I do feel like I'm using them quite a bit into 1. Also, quite a bit as well coming out of 3 whenever I kind of do a slide like that.
Murphy behind is pitting. Sparks in front is now 0.2.
Okay, it looks like 10th behind us disconnected, so we're guaranteed a P10. See if we can actually gain the position or not. Oh, that was a perfect exit.
The captain, Sparks, behind is now 0.8.
That was a shitty one. That was a shitty corner. Oh no! Yeah, I mean, if you have a shitty tunnel turn, it just sets you up for a really bad turn 3. Let's try to pull a gap. Because we are approaching 10 to go. That was bad because I was hitting on and off the brakes. Let's pull away, let's pull away, come on. Oh, it looks like he hit the wall again.
Sparks behind is increasing, but it's now 1.2 seconds. That lap time was 58.9. Okay, Corey, that's good consistency. Keep it up.
Even though that was a poor turn, that was a really poor turn. It's not that bad. Oh shit. Wah! Whoa. I could have sworn we was gonna hit the wall just then. Really, I just have to get that tonal turn right. And I can just pull away. Because each time whenever I mess up on that tonal turn, I lose time. Really, I think that's the case for late everyone, really. Unless they
my car sparks behind is increasing. It's now 1.6.
Unless like one of us hits the wall off of turn one or something.
Can't turn down from that bit here.
Ah, sweat. Yeah, it's getting in my eyes.
I can't even make the pit. The car's not turning enough.
How am I sweating that much? Like, it's only my face that's really sweating. So it seems like something has happened up front. With Brian. And it might be Gardner as well, because Gardner's seems like he's losing a lot of time. Actually, no.
Okay, Corey, the next car is Vinny.
Alright, so we're coming up on 5 to go. It sounded like Brian wanted to pit, but now he's not pitting.
Consistency, keep him coming.
Don't know exactly what's going on.
Sparks behind is now 1.4.
All right then. What a terrible first turn. Much better. Alright, so it's 3 to go. Pretty sure I can hold on to this position. Why did he say 2 more? Pretty sure we're not lapped.
to Sparks behind is now 1.2.
All right. Oh, looks like he made a mistake.
The time was 1 minute.
Alright, white flag. Looks like we have a pretty good gap
white flag,
to the
flag.
Car behind, so looks like we've got this P9 pretty steadily in the back.
Yeah, good one, Garrett. You were tough to catch.
Oops. That was a terrible turn. It's gonna set me up terribly for the tunnel and then the turn 3. Yeah, if you actually really mess up on turn 1, that sets you up really badly for the rest of the lap.
Good race, guys. Good season. Nice win, Garrett. Good run, Mike.
P9. Okay, it's over.
Thank you.
Congrats, Mr. Garrett Street.
Well, that was an exhausting race. Made it to the end. Didn't finish in last, so don't know what actually that's going to do to our season with this result. Forgot to actually mention at the beginning that this is a full that this was a full length race. ARCA race.
Everybody, I hope y'all had a fun season. I hope y'all will be back for next season.
Let's just park it up here for the season finale. And, that was a fun season. If you followed along, and once you are interested to join, there is links down below in the description. For the longest of time, there was actually broken before I realized what was going on. So, yeah. Oh, me. Thank you. Let's just do some season-ending donuts. Just to end off the season. I know it's more F1 style, but whatever. Just needing some time to mentally rest myself from that. Because that was an exhausting race. Sorry that for my quietness. But anyways, I don't really know if there's really that much, if any, incidents from that race. But we're going to look anyways, though. It's probably just going to be a whole bunch of wall hits. People going to the wall and stuff. Which I did a couple of times. Wall hit. Ooh. Ah, okay, so this was the incident. Okay, so. Yeah, see, normally I would say that there would be a yellow for that, like, in a normal broadcast, but because of iRacing and stuff, and we don't exactly have a active admin that's, like, that's off not racing that can throw a yellow at a moment's notice, per se. So, yeah, that kind of sucks. But, I mean, another wall hit. At least his race didn't totally get ruined. Ooh, a little loose. Wall hit and then raw grind. I think everyone hit that wall off the tonal turn. Difficult pit road entry. Yeah, I'm having a feeling the rest of these are just gonna be wall hits. And I feel like actually the replay is now broken. Yes, it is. oh well. Anyways, yes. Here are the results. Not gonna bring up that other screen because that's gonna be kind of, you know, that's kind of redundant whenever it comes to league races. At least for this one, I don't know. Unless it's easier to read the other screen, let me know if you would rather me bring up the actual results from the other fucking screen. But yeah, refinish ninth. Yeah, it's just that's actually kind of where I honestly expected us to finish 10th, but don't know exactly what was going on with the other two cars ahead of us. I guess we just could keep it together and be a little bit faster on the tires as they wore on. Actually, that kind of makes me think how worn the tires. Oh my god, I wore those fucking suckers out. Holy shit. Like I said, I burn tires up. Whenever I try to actively save them, I tend to not to. Anyways, that was one heck of a season. That was one fun season. Even though I was kind of frustrated at certain parts of it. In the end, I really did enjoy it, and we'll definitely be back for next season. But yeah, hope you enjoyed this video, and the next ARCA season will not be starting next week, but the week after that. So yeah, no league race next week. Or no league video next week, but the week after that. So yeah. Till then, see you next video.